So we have the moon swimming in Cancer right now, and the moon feel comfortable and it's home right now. It just went through its travels and it's back home to basically get a few breaks, few days of breaks. And of course the moon is going right back on vacation, where Jupiter is exalted and Neptune, aka Pisces, is exalted, where the meanings, the reasons, and the experiences that you basically go through the 360. Well, you develop all these currents, you develop all these arenas, and you start to basically build the architect and the life that you basically want to experience. Now with the moon in Cancer right here, with this moon in Cancer, so you need to go ahead and react and respond towards home, comfort, security, safety. And the moon is exalted in Taurus, in the Taurus season. So this is going to bring opportunities for your actions and your reactions and things that you are paying attention to and things that you are responding to. It's going to basically start formulating and taking shape and form. Now you need to basically put some form of love, some form of nurture, some form of care, and some form of being equipped with having some form of comfortability and some form of safety and security within your aspect of your home and your life. And of course, these appearances need to basically appear to be very caring. And you need to basically reconnect with these energies. You need to go ahead and, of course, put your focus and your vitality on the actions of Taurus and react and respond to the moon and Cancer energy. So basically start getting the ball rolling. This way you're going to have a stage to express what you basically are creative in when it comes to your endeavors. Now, this is going to be a sun sextile moon. So the moon is going to basically also sextile your north node, which is your spiritual growth and your spiritual aim. It's also going to basically put you into the perspective of having opportunities to bring the Uranus and Taurus energies towards the moon, making those opportunities towards Uranus. So you're going to have opportunities to change, be unique, be original, and start planting the right seeds and of course, start formulating the right growths. Now, also, you're dealing with the Pluto and Capricorn. So Pluto, wherever you have Pluto and Capricorn at, these energies can kind of like throw you off when it comes to areas that you need to take full power and control over. So what you basically need to utilize and do is you need to go ahead and blend these two in together, because you're going to also attract the opposite. So when the moon does get back into Capricorn, when we have the full moon in Scorpio, then it goes to Sagittarius and Capricorn, whatever the seeds and the energies you was planting when the moon was in Cancer, you're going to basically be receiving what you pushed out. And whatever you're pushing out with this moon in Cancer is what you're going to basically be attracting back from the full moon all the way to the raining moon. So it's up to you to basically plant the right seeds and, of course, have the right shit growing in your backyard. Now, first and foremost, if you got the moon in Cancer in your first house, we're going to go through the houses real fast. We're going to basically break this down real quick, too. We're going to get into the details. Now, Cancer in your first house, this is needing personal support when it comes to your home, your family, and of course, what you personally got going on in your life now. You're going to go through some power control issues and struggles when it comes to your relationships and things that you've been relating to. Now, you're also going to have Taurus in your 10th house, so you need to take action towards your status, what you're known for, and things that you're trying to kind of like build, what you want to kind of like build on. Actually, I'm lying. 11th house, that's what you need to be focusing on, 11th house. Now, 2nd house, you're going to have Taurus in your 12th house, so take action towards your spirituality. And of course, value the 2nd house being in Cancer, being that you have this here. So you need to be valuing your home, your family, and of course, what makes you feel comfortable. So you need some form of value and comfortability. Also, Cancer is exalted here, too. So you got the advantage by default within your house. So make sure you're valuing the right things. Also, you're going to go through some power control issues and some struggles when it comes to things that you deeply are connected with. Desires, passion, motivations, and shit like that. Or sexual urges can throw you off or deplete you. Now, if you got this in your 3rd house, you need to be taking full power and control and action towards yourself. Feel me? Yourself, which is the Taurus sun. Now, you need to be reactive, responding to some form of comfortability when it comes to your environment, your surroundings, your friends, your associations, and things that you got going on within your environment, or things that you are connected with, electronics, or devices, or friends, or groups, and things that matter. You basically need to get connected with that. And also, you're going to go through some power control issues and some struggles. And also, you're going to go through some discomforts when it comes to your 9th house. The experiences that you have within your life. The experiences may basically throw you off when it comes to your environment, your surroundings. So take full power control over that. Now, if you got this in your 4th house, your actions and what you need to be paying attention to is the 2nd house. Things you value. Now, what's going to basically help you out in this circumstance situation right here, you need to be reactive responding to your home, your family, your comfortability. You know what I mean? Or you need some form of emotional support when it comes to your home and your family, which can basically put you into the right aspects. Now, you're going to be placed into a circumstance situation of having all the support you might need. You're also going to be going through some power control issues when it comes to your status, your career, and of course your goals, your business, and your responsibilities, and the things that you're doing on a day-to-day basis. So be aware of that. Now, if you got this in your fifth house, you basically need to be basically paying attention towards your environment, your surroundings when it comes to Taurus season. Now, you need to be reacting, responding towards your creativity, your talents, your gifts. Value it, be clingy with it during the time. And what's going to throw you off is going to be the public or haters or enemies in the public that you're going to basically be going off from that. Now, if you got this in your sixth house, you basically need to be paying attention towards home and family when it comes to Taurus season. Now, when it comes to the sixth house, you need to be reactive responding to some form of work, routine, health. And you need to be basically be clinging on towards your work ethics and things that matter and be practical with that. Now, what's going to throw you off is going to be your dreams, your subconscious, and the feelings and emotions that you are dealing with behind the scenes. These things may basically be coming up and popping up. Taurus season, your focus is going to basically be predicated towards sixth house energies. Now, with this moon in Cancer in your seventh house, you basically need to be reactive to responding to your relationships, your partnerships, and clinging onto these things and relating with these things. Now, what can throw you off is going to be you, your personality, your personal life. Gonna basically kind of like throw this off or take you away from that shit because you're a workaholic Capricorn ascendant. Eighth house, you're gonna be placed into a circumstance situation of paying attention towards Taurus season, aka relationships. Now, when it comes to your moon sign is gonna be in the eighth house where the moon is actually sleeping here, it's full here. So, you're gonna be reactive, respond to some deep desires, some deep connections, and things of that matter. So, you need to be basically staying down till you come up. Now, what's gonna throw you off is gonna basically be your second house. The things you value, the seeds you planted. These things can basically destroy and destruct or come into light depending on what you was keeping into the dark and things that matter. You're also dealing with the South Node energy, so, which is in Scorpio, so be aware of that. Also, if you have this right here, your focus is going to be predicated towards Taurus season in the 8th house. Now, you're going to be reacting, responding to some form of meanings, reasons, principles, and the moon. It's kind of like it's going to be exhausted in this ninth house here. So you need to be reacting and responding towards your spiritual mechanisms, your experiences, your meanings, your reasons. Now, you're going to need to do that. Now, what's going to throw you off is going to be your home. It's going to be the people, places, and things that's in your home, the environment, your surroundings, and your neighbors or your community and shit. That's going to basically throw you off during the sound. So not try to take full power control over that and try not to allow that to throw you off. Now, if you got this here, you're going to be basically focusing on your experiences in life and your traveling system. Now, if you got this in your 10th house, you need to be reactive, responding towards responsibilities, duties, and obligations, of course, your career, your goals, and of course, your status. Now, the moon in Cancer don't really like being here, but it's always at work here. Now, what's going to throw you off is going to be your home, your family, your privacy, or that's going to kind of like throw you off during this time. So try not to allow that. Now, if you got this in your, if you got this in your 11th house, what you basically need to be doing right now is be reacting, responding towards your groups, your associations, and things that you are familiar with and connecting with, or the unknown. And what's going to throw you off is going to be your creativity, your talents, your gifts, and your hobbies. So be aware of that. And your focus is going to basically be predicated towards your status and what you're known for. And last but not least, you got this in your 11th house. Your focus is going to be predicated towards the 9th house. Now, last but not least, if you got this in your 12th house, you need to be reactive, responding towards your dreams, your spirituality, and imagination, and subconscious. Now, it's going to kind of like throw you off. It's going to be your work, your health, your routines, and things that you're doing on a day-to-day basis. And also, this house is exalted in Cancer. So, yeah.